My name is Seth Rudetsky. Here's my background if you care. I saw my first Broadway show when I was 4 and it was Hair. Ever since then, I've made Broadway my life. It's my joy and my muse, my mistress and my wife. Now, before you say you're white, you have no right to rapture. I say Robert Preston did it in The Music Man, so work!
Look, what do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
My problem is I overbook myself, you see? I schedule too much, I've got adult ADD. I host on Broadway radio, write books and play piano. I tour the country doing shows from Maine to Indiana. So watch me as I DJ, write, or play for some diva. By the end, you'll love Broadway. And you'll have Rudetsky fever.
This is me walking around the theater district, and if you notice, my hair is wet because I don't have an umbrella, not because of some amazing political statement. It's because every umbrella I buy, I literally lose within 5 minutes. Went to buy an umbrella, zero money in my wallet. Why would I ever be prepared and have money? My life is one, it's like not even interesting mistakes, it's just a string of boring irresponsibilities.
So for all the thousands of jobs that I have, the one day-to-day job that I always have is SiriusXM. I'm on every single day for 6 hours. SiriusXM is not just an entertainment building like the Brill Building. We share it with like a lot of corporate, I don't know, like Chase Manhattan or something like that. The point is, the elevator is always incredibly crowded with business people. So it's always all these people in suits, and I walk in on like a sports bra, or like a crazy tank top. So thank God now it's the weekend, so no one's around. Just me in the elevator. What's nice is that as soon as you enter SiriusXM, there's a whole wall where all the radio shows are displayed. So you have the really, really famous host. So there's an enormous picture of me, but there's no picture of me. There's so many different channels, so many different styles.
Sports, let's see, where's Broadway? It's a whole section for Broadway, I'm sure.
Surely they have a whole section of Broadway. Let me try to find it.
Let's see, traffic and weather. Okay.
Keep looking.
Christian? No.
Well, surely it's listed under Broadway.
So.
Okay, it's not listed under Broadway. It's Broadway. First of all listed under Standards, and it's combined with the Frank Sinatra channel. Because they're totally the same thing.
Sinatra, Broadway, I mean, hand in hand. Just keep calling me.
So I'm on 6 hours a day talking about Broadway. Well, it's 6 hours of music, and then I talk in between. And by talk, I mean babble. Okay, so here I am at the SiriusXM studios. Now, by the way, can you tell that this is not my studio? Let's look at his pictures all over the wall. Is it my picture? I've commandeered Cousin Bruce's studio to make it look like I have a big studio. I do not.
Normally, this is where I have to record. Just so you have the image, this is me all week long. Hey, everyone, it's SiriusXM, and I'm incredibly uncomfortable.
I'm Betty Buckley, and it's time for the amazing Seth Rudetsky and Seth's Big Fat Broadway.
So this is the board. I just want to do like this, but I don't actually know what it does. But I turn on my microphone, host microphone, click. Then I do this thing. I don't know what this does, but it has to be at 7. Something with your voice, I don't know what it does, because one time it wasn't at 7 and my producer was like, you're sounding crazy! Ever see the TV show Lost in Space? I know my host microphone, push it on. Hello! No makeup needed, no costume needed, I simply hit the button, and I'm on the air. I put on my headphones, or cans, watch this, hear my... Okay, so I'm just gonna put that on. Now, if you're really cool, you have one can on, one can off.
The moon out tonight.
What up, everyone? It is I, Seth Rudetsky, SiriusXM on Broadway. That was, by the way, Lindsay Mendez, who's currently starring in Godspell on Yield Broadway. All right, so here's a little Alex Corey. Now, Andrew Lippa, he was writing the show called The Wild Party. Then he said, Alex, I'm writing this show. I really want you to be in it. I wrote you a phenomenal song to sing. And she's like, you wrote me, she talks like this. She's like, you wrote me a song? I gotta do it then. So she said yes to doing The Wild Party because he wrote this great song for her. And then when she actually said yes, then he wrote the song. By the way, the song is phenomenal. Listen, and it ends on a crazy high belted note. Here we go.
SiriusXM is very big on DJs not sounding like typical DJs. They really want specific stories that relate specifically to what's going on. So all my years of working on Broadway and all my years of interviewing people and all my incredible work eavesdropping has allowed me to have very dishy and specific stories about every single song that I introduce. The lovely Kristen Chenoweth, currently starring in Good Christian Bells, where I think one of her lines is, "Cleavage makes your crucifix hang straight." Two things I know nothing about. Cleavages, and quite frankly, crucifixes. And actually being on a TV show, so three things. Yeah, don't have any actual career, but here I am on the radio. Yay, radio! When I was in college, I would invite my friends over to my college dorm room and I'd be like, listen to this, listen to that, listen to this, listen to that. And now I can actually just go like this. Listen to this, listen to that, listen to this, listen to that. Just, I love spreading Broadway music around the country and telling people what's great about it. And quite frankly, sometimes what's terrible. All right, everyone, I'm signing off. It is I, Seth Rudetsky. It's SiriusXM on Broadway. Please peace out. What does that actually mean? Get back to me. All right, so I'm done with SiriusXM. Now it's time to go for the next thing I'm late for, which is write my book, write my playbook column, and give Julie a piano lesson. By the way, my version of giving her piano lessons is once every 6 to 7 months. I'm always like, why don't you practice? Like, why don't you ever teach me? Touche. I read somewhere that there's a town that is seriously trying to pass a law that's illegal to walk while texting. I would be in jail right now if I lived in that town. Jailbird. I'm done with my job at SiriusXM, so naturally I'm going to go relax for the next few hours. What? No. Of course, I have 1,000 other things to do. That's how I live my life. I have to have a lot of things to do. I said to my therapist once, I said, God, I wish I could just meet a really, really rich guy and he could just support me and I could do nothing. And she was like, you would kill yourself. I was like, that's true. Which is coming up. Wow. It's amazing. I studied a lot of dance in college. I've had it. I'm out, people. Okay, I'm leaving SiriusXM, and the nice thing about where it's located is that it's in the heart of Times Square, aka Broadway. Hi, people. Welcome to my neighborhood. I don't actually live here. However, I work here every day, so it's my workahood. They added an enormous staircase. Nobody really knows why. It's not really comfortable to walk up or to sit on, but it exists. Here, watch. My glutes are going to be incredibly tight the whole time, so I'm actually exercising as I do this. Here's where all the Broadway theaters are. Now, Cheyenne Jackson, who's from somewhere crazy like Wyoming or something, he literally thought there was a theater on Broadway. What Broadway really means is that the theater has more than 500 seats. The Palace Theater's right over there, where Judy Garland gave her infamous concert. Priscilla's there right now. I've never done an actual Broadway show at the Palace Theater, but I did something called the Easter Bonnet Competition. That way I did the Ritz on Broadway, which I was in, and I did Pat of the Pone on Broadway right down there. And then on 49th Street, the Eugene O'Neill, I did Grease for like 3 years. I'd spent a lot of years playing Phantom of the Opera. It's down there, this way, Phantom. Oh, I did Seussical. Where was Seussical? When you've done as many Broadway shows as I've done, and when you're severely old, forget. Ginkgo biloba. The stairs are terrifying. Not since Carol Channing. Hello, Dolly. Okay, here's how a New Yorker walks. And now tourists. It's a 30 degree angle. It's all it takes. New Yorker, tourist. Okay, this is the Marriott. I did Victor Victoria here. Victor Victoria, Phantasmagoria. It's a hotel and a theater. It's a cafetorium. That's Lunt Fontanne. I never did a show there. This is the Richard Rogers Theater, which used to be called something else. I don't remember what. But I did two Broadway shows here. I did How to Succeed with Matthew Broderick, replaced by who? Do you remember? Anybody remember? John Stamos. And I also did Seussical. Now it's Porgy and Bess. Not really right for it. I've actually known Audra for around 20 years. I've known her for 5 Tony Awards. Back to 0 Tony Awards. I actually played her senior recital from Juilliard. I ran into her recently, and I am wrong for Porgy and Bess, but we talked about maybe doing a non-equity bus and truck tour. Porgy and Bess, we have the poster art. That's kind of as far as we've gotten. So, yeah. Love to hear percussion. Okay. Love to hear it. Yep. I've sat in the pit orchestra of so many Broadway shows And I've listened to the show on stage and I've thought, oh my God, I would totally rewrite that line. Or I thought, oh my God, I would say that line differently. I'm Dr. Ted Scheider, a disaster expert. Point is, I've always wanted to not just be the piano player. I've wanted to also rewrite the script, star in the show. Actually, it was four women only with Bonnie Franklin. I wanted to kind of do everything. And me and my friend Jack Plotnick wrote a show. Okay, everyone, I need you all to walk immediately to the lifeboats, orderly and like this. Any heavy movement could trigger a massive earthquake. Disaster is based on the slew of popular disaster movies in the 70s. We've taken every single disaster from all those movies and we put it into one musical. People, it's imperative that we evacuate into the hallway. When the boat turns upside down, the floor-to-ceiling ratio is small enough that we will not be injured. So all these disasters befall one big group of people that are all for one night on a floating casino in the Hudson River. I am a disaster expert, and for a brief period of time, I was a Mormon.
I said moron.
1968 Haiti volcano did affect my hearing. We have an earthquake, a tidal wave, a fire, shark attack, piranhas, killer bees, and more.
There's no tidal wave coming. The lifeboats are secure.
How do we know there are enough lifeboats to go around?
We're doing disaster as a one-night fundraiser for Only Make Believe. We're raising all this money for this great organization that brings theater to hospitalized children. Nobody's getting paid.
This is weird. This is weird to be over me, just FYI.
That means if they have even the semblance of a paying job, they're going to miss rehearsal to go to that job. Hence, barely anyone's at rehearsal.
Miss Verona, your fans and numerous reporters await your singing. You wouldn't want to read Washed Up Disco Diva Deserts Earthquake Victims, would you?
So for every single person that's missing, they're being replaced by our stage manager, Lois Griffin, who she will be the first to admit is not an actress.
Why, listen to this.
Disaster is a jukebox musical, meaning that the whole score is from the 70s. But all the songs have a crazy, twisty double meaning. Now, my character is a disaster expert, and I was at one point married to Dr. Wo Ching Lee, who I call Wo. She died on her honeymoon in a volcanic explosion. I'm devastated over her loss, so naturally I sing feelings. And when I get to the chorus, I go, feelings, wo, 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 feeling. Wo Ching, wo. Double meaning.
Hear me now and understand. He's gonna find me some peace of mind. Not if that peace of mind won't stay. I'm gonna find a better way.
I produced a lot of benefits, and really my thing is either you're incredibly famous and you're super talented, or you're not famous at all and you're super talented. One or the other, and disaster is the exact same way. So I have people that have done tons of Broadway shows, for instance, Lauren Kennedy.
Marzo, what do you think if it takes
up a step?
Up a step or a half step?
I don't know.
Yeah.
And I have people that have never done a Broadway show. For instance, Lucretia Ross. Giving someone a break because I can't get someone better. I wanted Lucretia to play this role.
You better knock.
Well, I saw Lucretia in this little tiny workshop years ago, and when I was writing the script, I'm like, she's perfect for it. She's never done a Broadway show before. I tracked her down. What's that noise?
It sounds like they're banging on the floor.
I called her. I said, I'm dying for you to star on the show. She's like, I can't. I'm in Kansas City. And I was like, guess what? We're paying for you to fly in. Listen how she changes. The way I love me is frightening to come from the bottom.
Here. The way you love me is frightening.
This is a combination of incredibly fun and incredibly terrifying. So much fun because I can't believe something that was on my computer screen is now being done live in front of me. Horrifying because pretty much no one can ever be at rehearsal, ever. What was perhaps psychic of me is that the show is called Disaster, and I think it may wind up being the title.
Baby.
classical music since my senior recital at Oberlin.
He sounds beautiful.
It was a while ago. Thanks for the ass kiss. So I'm going to go. Okay, so my new talk show is about to go onto the air. This is one of my guests, my good friend Nell Snaitis, amazing opera singer.
Am I playing it right?
Yeah. Oh, so
sensitive. I'll do it over the shoulder.
Love it. Yeah, yeah.
I can't stand having photos taken where I'm just like this. So I always try to be creative. I have a good time. I think the photographers are like, you're annoying and not funny. Now I'm extra greasy today. Look at the hair. It's like weird, creepy, just oil. Okay, I gotta get something itchy fun. This is the serious wall where people sign it, but it's passive progressive because actually it's a removable wall. So it's not really called signing anything. It's called we're gonna take it off and wipe it off one day. It's passive progressive. Shockingly, I haven't eaten. I'm actually being healthy because I'm being filmed right now. Okay. I did my pilot of this talk show in December, and 6 months later, we're beginning. They've actually given me a whole staff. I feel very, very fancy. This is my producer. We're going over last minute details. Why am I doing a brand new musical and a brand new talk show the exact same week? Because I thrive on stress. So does my ulcer. I could say, wait, let's hear the actual recording from Full Monty, and we could just play the actual recording during the show. Let's say we cut Nell, and then you think it'll be the right length?
Off the top of my head, we are actually about 5 minutes over.
All right, so if you cut the span, you think Spanish should be enough?
Yeah,
well, try it. We don't know whether to put the song during the show or we're going to add it during post. Post stands for post-production. It's also the maker of some of my favorite cereals. Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Sure, any other rehearsal in the studio, or can we start seating the audience?
We may need a soundtrack for Nell's voice, but we could always do that during the actual show.
Yeah, we can do that just like a couple seconds.
My talk show is called Seth Speaks. It's not just Broadway, it's essentially anything I want it to be.
I think we got.
I decided I had to have a live audience for this show. I did the pilot with no audience at all, and it made me crazy because there was complete crickets in the studio, so I said I had to have an audience. I'm praying to God they laughed during the show.
I'm currently studying at the American Musical and Dramatic Academy. When I was doing The Mystery of Robin Drood, I came across Seth's deconstruction of the big finale number writing on the wall, and it just totally helped me, and I was like, who is this guy?
I'm shoving food in my mouth.
I love him. He's amazing.
Yeah, is Nell here?
I think she's
Nell. Thank you, Seth.
Well, you gotta just do the sound check. Hold on. Then you can go back to babbling. This is Nell, our first guest. Okay, so we're gonna sound check. I never wear headphones in this.
Yeah, we've done a bunch of things together over the years. A couple of the Actors Fund benefits, hair on the 20th century, a few concerts.
First, I discovered him on the internet, and then we found out that he does live shows, and we went to go see him.
Okay, this girl, Bibi, is my audience member. She moved to New York City to try to like get into theater. She's now starring on the new Ryan Murphy TV show, The New Normal. I was giving her career advice. Her career has now completely surpassed mine. Bibi, do you have any advice for me? Any advice?
That's for now.
Excellent. Thank you.
Too. And
then I'll mention you.
So we can actually start.
I decided to write my own opening number, and now I'm singing it because we're on the air. When he cries, Seth leaks. After the gym, Seth reeks. When he closes his eyes, Seth peeks. And for the next hour or so, Seth speaks. And I've got a lot to say. Hello, live studio audience. So I knew I had to start with a big A guest. So I actually went to my phone book and called big movie / Broadway star, Patrick Wilson.
This is Patrick.
Patrick and I met back in the late 90s doing a musical by Barry Manilow.
How are you guys?
A show called Harmony, which has not come to Broadway yet, and it's such a good show. Patrick was beyond not famous, and I remember meeting him and watching him rehearse and going, wow, he's gonna be a star. Are you eager for a star? You'll have to wait until, son, I introduce the sexy Patrick Wilson. Yeah, he's the man.
Hey.
last time I saw you, literally, you were getting married. And now how many kids?
17.
That's because you know that... look at Debbie's face. She actually believes it. He's joking, dear. He's joking.
I have two awesome boys. What
are their ages? Then he got the lead in the Full Monty, and I became the sub, as usual, always a bridesmaid, sub piano player in the pit of Full Monty. I love being in the pit and hearing Patrick sing Man. Amazing! I had to ask him about it. That last note, how did you do that last note? Man! And not kill yourself.
I don't know.
We were all in the pit saying, like, why is Patrick? I remember the conductor saying, I begged Patrick to take it down, and you didn't want to.
No, and the reason was, and David Yazbek, who wrote the musical lyrics, because when we sat there at the piano in San Diego when we were doing the show, he said, I want you to sing at the top of your range. Now, of course, I'm thinking 8 times a week, but I think there was something. The song doesn't sit as well. Try it down a step, and it just, you're out of... Right. You're out of work. Your pride is missing. They call you a jerk. Now take it up the step. You're out of work. Your pride is missing.
Yeah.
They call you a jerk. It's like you're yelling. And that's what he wanted. And he wanted that because that's where the timbre of my voice is just sort of, although it sits a little lower now, but it just sort of rode there. So you kind of, you're talking like this the whole time. So it actually made sense.
Guess who wasn't happy about it? Your understudy. Anywho! If you don't know, the Full Monty ends with a big nude scene. But the audience would never really get to see anybody nude because there was a light that shined right in back of the nude guys that blinded the audience. So they'd be nude like this, but in back of them was a light, and the light would shine on the audience, and you'd never actually see the nudity. I guess, except for once. Just tell quickly about when you're doing the nude scene and you realize the lights were off.
So as the song is going on, we realize that we're not in the right cue. Now, we don't know if we're too early or too late, but we just realize because we're upstage and there's like spotlights downstage and like, okay, well, that's wrong. And then we go down there and the lights are back upstage and now we're down to our underwear. And then we let it go, boom, and we drop everything. And yes, so we are naked, the lights come up, and I swear, how old are you, by the way?
10.
Yeah, I lock eyes with a girl about your age. And I thought of all the people that I have to look at. I have to look at a nice young girl like you, and I felt terrible, and then I wanted to look at her mother, like, what? First of all, like, I'm sorry. This, I didn't mean this, but then like mad, like, why did you bring her?
Right. So I really wanted this new talk show to not just have interviews, and I added a game called Celebrity. Okay, he wrote the producer, it's hilarious.
Mel Brooks.
Correct. Okay, last name, Anderson blank.
Cooper.
Right, and first name, in the Rocky Horror Show, the name of the guy.
Brad Cooper.
Yes. My audience filled out names, and then I gave clues, and Patrick had to guess who the celebrity was. 9, 10, 11!
Patrick Wilson.
He got 11 in 1 minute. Very impressive.
We'll be back with more Seth Speaks. One more.
I added a whole advice segment. Spend that money and take like singing, dancing, and acting lessons and get an actual degree.
Nice to see you guys. Take care. Thanks.
I think the show worked. The audience seems to like it. Now I just have to get another A-list guest for next week. Incredible amounts of pressure. And disaster rehearsal went well, considering nobody was actually there. Next week I'll be much further into disaster rehearsal. And hopefully I'll keep up the A-list type guest for Seth Speaks, or else it'll be Seth Speaks starring Sally Rudetsky. My mother. All right, everybody, cut. Thank you all for coming. I'll see you tomorrow.